Well met. Well met. Well met. Well met. Well met. Well met. Well met.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to DDOwiki Talk, episode 52. I am just going around getting a few things real quick. With my headset, I had to swap headsets this morning. Oh, good update. Doesn't sound like my game sounds are coming through, so let me see if I can fix that real quick. My background music. Sound system speakers. All right, let me check that real quick.
Sound system.
So I still don't hear my game sounds. Well, on the bright side for you, I guess that means you guys won't hear their ding. So, I'll be here. Alrighty. Alrighty. Absolutely. Let me see if I can get you a chat link real quick. Actually, I'm not even in the right chat room. Let me see if I can fix that. I want to be in this chat room. And the invite for this chat room. Is this one. Okay, so live voice chat with ShoeMaker. Right there. do that real quick. Alright, so let's get started with populating our code giveaway list here today. The deal was that if we hit 50 viewers, I'd give away a starter pack. And if we only get to the 30 to 49 range, then I would do I'd still do a 500 turbine point code or DDO point code. So let's see here. Who do we have this morning? We have Antidote. We have MNEMMY. We have Darius. 1680. That's who we have so far this morning. Spread the word. Nope. Looks like my other computer's up, so let me go post a LFM up with that one. I don't remember which server it's on, so. Headset, even though it's exactly the same model, doesn't seem to be as good quality-wise as the other one. In order to be eligible for the drawing, you need to say hi in chat. Good morning. Looks like we have Bortech and ZRMI as well. Bortech 73. ZRMI. You do not have to be a follower, although following doesn't hurt. You just have to say hi in chat. So let's say this is episode 52. There we go. So let's take a look at our recent changes while the other slate Zor. So let's see here. Let's reload this page. And scroll back down here. January 10th. I had my birthday like. Still hasn't loaded there. Oh, right. All right, so Sea Hound added some stuff to starter items. Crew did some work on update 34. I added some stuff to my to-do list. To-do lists are always a good thing to check out. Deleted and restored guild level because there was a couple edits in there that needed to be cleaned out. The block log, you see I blocked Abolisher for 1 second. That was just so that I could put a note. It didn't work the way that I wanted, so I had to do a double user rights change. Let's see here. Are you getting feedback? The little creaking noise? That's not actually feedback. That's poor quality of the microphone itself. Yeah, I have one. If I do that, that won't work anyway. Let me try something. Let me see if what happens when I plug it in. What am I working on today? Just going through the recent changes at the moment. Let's add you to the attendee list here. Is this working any better? All right, so it's a battery issue with this headset. No, we'll just have to do it plugged in. And then when I want to go somewhere, I'll have to unplug it. Alrighty, so we got Zolar, Drexian being worked on, some new items here for shackles, chains, and rings. I thought there were already pages for those. Maybe not. DDO information project, search and spot, and traps and locks have been working on by Doopy. Alright, so we got HIR UI 81. Up to 9 out of 50 already. That's a good start. A little bit of a tickle in my throat, so I might cough occasionally. UL this week went through a lot of quests and used calculated XP. I don't know that was really necessary. I plan on doing some changes to the quest template, which will automatically do that, but that's okay. And then some crafting information to some collectibles. And then Rendal added some CRs to some monsters. And Borrower was on last night, this morning, at 20 past the hour. Apparently he lost his password. He'll have to get in touch with Zevo. Good morning, Ninth Pawn. Of the way there, yay! And the stream's just started. Even though I was a little bit late. Oh, right. I was gonna give you guys a link. Oh, I thought I already did. Yep, right there. There's a link if you want to chat with me with voice. You'll have your icon pop up over my head right here when you talk, or next to my head over there. Right about there. And people will be able to hear you on stream. So, let's take a look at my to-do list here. Bit of a sneeze there. Thank you. Set up a hotkey so that I can mute both Discord and the stream when I want to sneeze. Alright, so I wanted to make a Twitch chat thingy, API URL, not useful for this. Let me go take a look at this other computer real quick. So I really don't want to do the API one, the Twitch one right now. It's JavaScript and it's just too much work for a little 2-hour stream. So what else do we have? Make a script. I don't really want to do JavaScript today. Set of consistent welcome block templates for specific situations. So it looks like I need a generic block template. I have the unacceptable username, the generic welcome, and the spam username. It's like I have a lot of JavaScripting I want to do. But let's start by creating blocked. Good morning, VTO Mazvik. All right, let me load in over here. So I'm going to want this. This and that. Good morning, Durand. I guess I can turn down my front fans now. Hopefully the temperature stays down at below 60. It was up to 68 per minute there. Let me put my alrighty. Hear my microphone popping in and out. Alrighty. So, doesn't look right. Do a show preview, there we go. I'm creating a template for blocked users. It'll work. There we go. We now have a block template. Going through our to-do list here. Reformat this so it's easier to see. There we go. Actually, now that I have a consistent effort of that, and boom, 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 boom. Alrighty. What does CE in the edit summary mean? CE in the edit summary means copy edit. It's an editor's note for just minor tweak. Let's take a look at these POIs that are over a year old. And special pages here. It should have been now instead of no. Yes, I can't spell. Bump that discussion. Have a CC. Good morning, Phoenix. Okay, so what do we got here? New color changes for holidays. As is. Wanted to change Valentine's from this to one of those. Easter, a little bit more contrast, that's good. Good morning, Xander. Let's see, did I put Phoenix in yet? I did not, so we got Phoenix. Windale 93, and we've got Isander, and we've got Admin 337. Now we're up to 16 out of 50. Keep them coming in. We need 50 people to say hi in chat. So if you're in there lurking, wake up and say hi in chat. Hey, Habby, are you there? Let's see here. Ow. Okay, so I need an editor of his channel. I'll have to fix that. Let's see here. Habanero in here? Not yet. Okay. Hey, Noble Pirate. Good morning, No Bob. Say hi in chat. Good morning, Noble Pirate. Actually, let me go like this. Yeah. Talk page. Like that. On face. Save. Alrighty, clean that right out. That'll be two less POIs I gotta put up there. If those get resolved quickly. Three wanted categories. I think it was at one last week. Let's take a look here. Lightning lore items. 15 and 18. Good morning, Italy. Afternoon, Italy. Evening, Italy. Whatever it may be. 15. LAS, USA. 19. We need at least 11 more to give away a 500 DDO point code. And if we get 21 more, right? 31 more. Then we'll have enough to do the starter pack. Okay. That should go down to one there. And it is. (clears throat) 322 orphaned pages. Adam Mirsky is a former executive director. What links here? Nothing. I've got 27 viewers according to XSplit. So let me go for this one. Let me go T developer. We're gonna add Adam Mirsky. Exactly. Good morning, Grandern. Uh-oh. 500 error, that's not good. It can be. Let's see here. I need to add in Grandern. Gives us 20. Do I have Durand yet? I do not. D-U-R-R-A-N-D. Oh, he is already in there somewhere. Oh, right there. I missed it. Okay. Let's see here. I know that it's still got an LFM up on... Alright, let me reply to some tells here. those are taken care of. Let me see here. Do I have any tells over here? Nope, nothing over there that's any new. All right. Let's see here. Check over here real quick. I don't see any tells. All right, plug me back in. Oh. Almost time for our coffee refill break. Alrighty. Adam Mursky's in there. Got a space though. Missing a space. I didn't want to edit that. Back. Edit the whole thing. For the next update 34, I believe that it's going to have Tower of Frost as a new quest. I believe that they're trying real hard to get Reaper Mode in there. Although it may be pushed out based on what I've heard about them having some issues with it in testing. Well, let's go take a look at what's on the list there. See what else there is. Update 34. Reaper difficulty, Tower of Frost. That's from Lamania. Let's see here. I don't know what else they're working on for it. Let me see here. Update 34. There's some named items in the new quests. Update 34. Redirection. This is mostly Reaper and one new quest, Tower of Frost. Although I believe that they're planning on trying to get it out the end of this month, beginning of next month, and then update 35 for the anniversary should be out. I think they said they wanted to get it out by March. So, let's see what In Development has. Maybe they can have more there. Future updates. Update 34. Winter festivals, winter festival, ice games. Possible updates to all festivals events in the update that takes them live. Oh, I'm plugged in. Might have just been while I was moving around. It will not be Ravenloft. That's currently slated for an expansion next year. Reaper difficulty won't be December. World character transfers, if they haven't already been re-enabled, should be, I would think. Paid for transfers directly with turbine points, it's out of date, it's DDO points now, already in Lord of the Rings, yep. See it by the end of the year, Harper's Travelarium, new building in the marketplace. Evening Star might be an easy way to get back and forth between realms. Yes, Andy. Okay, so yep. If it actually comes out, update 35 is Dragonborn. It won't be Kobold. I should collapse those. Only the most up-to-date one should be available. Now, looks like the development page needs some work. Alright, so... yes, which will restore the need for healers and appropriate tanks, which makes me kind of happy because I always used to enjoy playing a healer. What was I gonna do? Discord. So, we have a Discord channel, which you go to DDO:Discord on the DDO Wiki, or there's actually a link right here at the top of the page for IRC chat and Discord. You can see our members, whoever's online at the moment. Spectre's a bot. DSL is a bot. I don't know why bots show up there like that. And you just hit the connect button. And it will automatically bring you to Discord. And it will take you to the announcement page, which says, welcome to the Discord server for DDOwiki. It's a pleasure to have you here. Following is a brief introduction definition of roles and channels available on this server. Please indicate if you are an editor of DDOwiki by linking your user page, http://ddowiki.com/uexample. This will allow a member of staff to assign the appropriate editor, VIP, super user, administrator, bureaucrat, or steward roles for you. Looks like I need to work on this a little bit, but that's okay. Not everyone here is an editor. People who just browse the wiki for information are welcome as well. It's a great place to report inconsistent data or ask for clarification. We even have a special role for you of reader. Please indicate if this is a role for you. We have specialized roles for people with certain talents. Let me pull this up real quick. We have a couple more people to add. We have, let's see here. We have the TM Trainer Effect, and we have CBS Pyro. And we have some Amaref dude. I haven't already added him, which I hadn't. There we go. Purpose of Discord. We're going over the purpose of Discord right now. We have advanced templating for those that are more advanced with creating and editing templates. We have DPL for those familiar with the dynamic page list extension, willing to create inquiries and help others. We have a JavaScript/jQuery for those familiar with JavaScript or jQuery and are willing to work on gadgets, user scripts, etc. We also have the following text channels. We have Staff Room, for members of staff to discuss Discord server-oriented stuff. Announcements, which is this channel, recent changes, currently disabled due to RSS feed bot being broken and offline. This will be a channel where special recent changes will be posted. Village Pump is our general wiki-related chat. Tech Chat is if you need some help from someone with specific tech skills. Questions, comments, and concerns. Need help with templates or DPL or jQuery or something of that nature. DDOwiki Talk is a place to find information about this show right here. Administrators Notice Board, want to see what the administrators are up to? This is a place to go. Everyone can see you must be an editor to comment. There's actually no logs channel at the moment, although that will be restored shortly. I don't know why it's not there. Oh, it probably is there. I'm just not an administrator on this account here. This is my Mindflayer Fred account. And then everyone check out... I can get rid of that. Movember is over. And you can go to recent changes, which is going to be empty for now. It used to be Robo Naitori posting recent changes in here. Village Pump. See stuff going on in here. People asking for help. For example, the most recent one was... Habreno saying, is it possible for somebody to expand the AC mob castle level template past 200, 100? Maybe to 300 AC and 150 CL? Not aware of how the table was originally calculated, or I do it myself. I asked for a link. He sent me a link to AC chance to be hit. A little bit of discussion about it, whether or not it's of any use or not. Who knows what Reaper is going to do? Might want to scale it to 400 to be safe. So I created a Google spreadsheet, which we can actually take a look at, which is a new table, adjusted the formatting. This is all I can fit in a page. Updated version of it. Went over that last week, I believe. Updated it. Purge cache in Firefox. Control Shift R. And then it's written down on the bypass page. A couple new people joined the channel after last week. Some roll me stuff. Some more new people. Agu Moore, even though it probably should have been in tech chat because it's a DPL question, but he asked if DPL was borked. Clear cache, refresh, whatever, and it's saying dynamic page list, no results. There was an issue with it. I'm guessing it has to do something to do with it showing as no space. I'll look into it. A few minutes later, resolved. So there's a chance to be hit table if you want to take a look at that sometime. You're welcome to comment on it. And it is possible for us to extend it. I just have not done so yet. Defender AC, attacker bonus, which is CR times 2.5. Can't see the other part because it's off the edge of the screen over there. But it tells you color-coded the same way. If it's 100%, it's 100%. Even though technically it would be much higher up here. It'd be like 1,000% of getting hit. That's the same way as fortification, where they could bypass AC. I should look into that. Maybe I need to change this to allow it to go up to 200% or something. We actually also have a Lamania channel for when Lamania is online, if you want to ask questions about Lamania-related stuff. Tech chat. See that people ask things about... what was the last one? Habrano asked, if I pull up the main page, I don't have a tab showing for the bot edits. As soon as I navigate to recent changes, right below that on the sidebar shows up today's bot edits under navigation. Yes, I'm logged in both cases. It's working as intended. There's an extra line in the sidebar that says, if page name is recent changes, then show today's bot edits. It keeps the sidebar when you're not on that page. When you're in the administrator's notice board on any of the pages of it, it actually has a list of all the pages of the administrator notice board over there as well. DDOwiki Talk. Got the YouTube archive there. Administrator's notice board. I don't have permission to talk there because I have no permissions on the server. We got some pin stuff up there, which I need to go over again. But yep, it's a great place to chat. I am always, always there. Even when I'm sleeping, sometimes I wake up when people post stuff there. It's got a free mobile app. It's also got some voice channels, which you can't see behind my thing here. Let me make that disappear for a minute. So if you go over here on the side, you can see all the channel names, and we even have some voice channels that you can pop into. Apparently, I don't have the one for DDO stream in here. Let me see if I can find the DDO stream one. There it is. I can add a new server, join a server, pop that in there, join, and now I am in the DDO stream one. Brings me right into voice chat here. Ooh, I hope that doesn't start doubling up on me. So let's see here. It's feeding back into myself. All right, so here we go. So we have a schedule one, which I probably need to update. Shoe Cobbles isn't on anymore. Streaming now shows you when people are streaming Dungeons & Dragons online. Those probably need to be deleted. The bot was offline earlier this morning due to probably a Discord API issue. See that it shows that I'm streaming. It's got schedule here, and then the DDO stream channel where you can actually chat. There's actually another channel that you can't see called host only, because this isn't a host account. As you can see, when DDO stream itself is streaming. I'll probably condense that to make it smaller. It's kind of spammy, because we got Demi in here, who I believe is a frequent viewer now. So let's pop over onto my other account here. Nemi can get frequent viewer. Let's see here. Ninth pawn can get frequent viewer. Mind Flayer Fred can get frequent viewer. Okay, let's see here. Good morning, Iron Hands. Yes, your second week, and that makes you a frequent viewer as far as I'm concerned. Chatting here gave me, joining the server set gave me a tell that said, welcome to DDO Discord server. You can find out which show host does each day by typing the case-sensitive name of the host preceded by a bang. For example, to see what shows Cordovan host, type bang Cordovan in the DDO stream channel. So we can do that. Bang Cordovan, it is case-sensitive. I will tell you that Cordovan is a host of Wednesday's weekly Wednesday live stream at noon and Friday's Friday afternoon at noon Eastern. He's also the Standing Stone Games community manager and the guy to contact if you'd like to host a show on the DDO stream channel. Preferred methods of contact, forum, Twitter, and Facebook with direct links to each one of those through the Google service. We get... Discord's a great thing, if you ask me. I am always there, so if you wanted to get a hold of that, would be the way to do it. We also have a IRC chat channel, but I don't... Even though I'm always there, I don't actually monitor it very often. So you may be waiting a very long time for me to respond. You can see our DDO Wiki IRC page we have a sorcery net. Hey, thanks for the follow. Let me actually bring up the Twitch chat. Hey, Foam. Let's put Iron Hands in here. And Foam Mets. 25 out of 50. We need 5 more to get the DDO point code. We've got half an hour left. We need at least 5 more for the DDO point code. And then 25 more in order to do our... See, that's here on this page as well. You can go right into Sorcery or Freenode. Sorcery Net, we have the DDO channel here. And we have a DDO Wiki channel here. Leroy Jenkins was there.
Another one? Really?
At 4 o'clock this morning. Who was that follow? Foam, thank you, Foam. and then on Freenode, we have a DDO and a DDO Wiki. And Leroy Jenkins was there as well at 4 a.m. You can see the topic for this is, you can't see the topic. It basically says you should go to Discord instead. You're more likely to find somebody. But yeah, we got some stuff there. Let's let's add MJDMHD18, add attendee, save, okay. Shrink that down. Roll this bar down, we're up to 26 now. So 322 should go down to 321 because we fixed Adam Mirsky. It's probably cached. So we'll have to wait for it to be cleared out. Some of these will always be orphans, because there's no place to really link them from. Death's Door. What's that? Disambiguation page. So for this one, we could do... Nope, I don't want Shadow Crypt. I want Trinket and Shield. And I can go Edit, and at the top of the page, I can go... See, also Death's Door. Item Death's Door. We have a CLSO template, I just have to figure out what it is. Maybe it's 4. Oh, time for a coffee refill, I think. None. Template. C also, lowercase. Okay. There, now this page will no longer be a dab because there's 2 pages that link into it. And let's head over to recent changes and refresh it. orphan pages is down to 321. You can see that that's going down. And I will be back in just, 3 minutes. My mic might be muted. Looks good on my end. Might have just been a delay. Alrighty. Ah, still has the orphan tag on it. Can you hear me now? Alrighty, let's do our recent changes here. New there. Good, good, good. Alright, we've got some stuff done there. I've decided that since I got a 20-minute late start, I'm going to run a little bit over 10 o'clock. So it'll give people more chance to get in here. I'd like to give away something this stream. Let your guildies and your friends know to get in here and say hi in chat. XSplit is showing me as having 31 viewers. Good morning, Migo. If the lurkers were to say hi, we would have enough to do the drawing for the DDO points at very least. So, how does it work? At the end of the stream, or just before the end of the stream, if this is up to at least 30, I will push the roll for winner button, and it will draw a winner out of somebody that said hi in chat. And if your name that it pulls up, you will be the winner. We're at 29 out of 50. The way that I do the giveaways is I send the code through the Twitch inbox. There is a link to the Twitch inbox. Twitch is showing 29. Looks like we lost a couple of viewers. Ah, there we go. Good morning, Gummy Bears. That gives us 30 that we need. So we will be able to do the DDO point giveaway at the end of the stream. If we can get 20 more viewers between now and when I end the stream, I'll be doing a starter pack giveaway instead. I'd much rather do the starter pack giveaway. Starter pack includes the Catacombs Adventure Pack, the Fiendish Scorpion Pet, a permanent cleric hireling of Ellery Thistledown, which is a level 3 cleric, can cure wounds, remove paralysis, and much, much more is what they use as the description. 5 excellent experience elixirs. And 250 DDO points. Ooh, it's got a typo in there. I need to fix that. Thank you. Nope, shoot. Nope, Titans aren't allowed. Oh, all right. I'll add Titan. But if you win, Titan, if you win, I'm gonna re-roll. If it's a DDO points. If it's a starter pack, you can win it. I'll allow you to win the starter pack, but no DDO points for you. The tyranny of Shoe. Alrighty, so this is what I want to give away. And we need 19 more people to do it. Fiendish Scorpion Pet. Oh, I should note that this is per server. So you get all of these things. You get Catacombs on every server. You get a Fiendish Scorpion Pet, a Cleric Hireling, and 5 Excellent Experience Elixirs on every server. Shade? No, I don't need shades. It's not bright in here. Go away, kitty. I'm not feeding you right now. I'm busy. Go to bed. Go on. Alright. So, let's see here. Recent changes. Let me take a look at the homepage real quick. Curious about something. So it looks like we don't have update 34 in here yet. And I would like to make an update 34. I would like to make an update 34.1. So let me edit update 33. Let's blow this up a little bit. Let's copy all of this, go 34. Oh, looks like there is a 34, it just hasn't been added yet. Okay. To be determined, late January or early February, Tower of Frost. Items. Reaper difficulty. No preview. That is not a question that I could answer personally. There. So that looks like West Tower of Frost. HN14. EN28. Trims that down a little bit. Clean up on aisle 2. Okay, so now I can go to the home page and I can click on edit for what's new. And we're going to start with 34. Save page. Update 34, Lamania preview is there. Reaper, new quests, new items, release notes. So this information will be on the homepage now. If you ever want to see what happened in what update, on the homepage, actually I can close this now that we're done with that and go back over to here to the homepage, reload the page so we can get the new and improved with update 34. You can see it's got the Lamania symbol there. Should update the link for that. Instead of the file, it should go to the release notes anyways. But anyway, you'll see that we got a scroll bar down here. If you ever want to see what update something happened, all of the updates, all the way back to update 1, are in that scroll bar. I'm thinking I'd like to add another bar underneath the top bar here for release date. Put the release date in there. I might do that later. Add release dates to those so we can track the release dates. I'm also tempted to just put it in the bottom corner over here, or on the bottom of each one. Could probably trim out some of those. Actually, let me clean up some of those. History, recently closed windows. Let's go here. All right. So we got this. Let's blow it up a little bit more. 150%. Let's edit that one. Edit that one. Edit that one. 23, 22, 21, 20. Just gonna edit the dates here a little bit. Event closed. I wanna condense these a little bit. 2015, 11, 09. That though. Dense. Condense. Okay. April 16 to 22. Save. This one is going to be February 26. March 8th. What year was that? Was that 2015? I don't even know what year things were. Last edited in 2015. First edited in 2014. Oh, that would be 2014. January 26th, February 15th, 2014. We've got, let's see here, SANJILUV. December 2, January 4, because if I'm going to add the dates to the template at the top, then the date, the year will already be there. Absolutely. This channel multiple times a day. I'll throw up the schedule in a minute. So we've got, let's see here, Over Von and Da Tranio. A lot of difficulty with traps, and they wreck me. Traps on higher difficulty level. Well, you're a new player, so what I would recommend, although I might be biased, what I would recommend would be go to the wiki, go to the DDO user DDO stream channel here, go check out previous shows, and go to Shoe Cobbles A and check out the Drow Rogue mechanic build. If you're looking to build a rogue, there is a build for you. All the way up to level 20, I believe. I might need to upload a little bit more there, but that should go all the way to level 20. And welcome, Pin. You can, but it wouldn't be very productive. So what you'll need to do is either get a rogue hireling, or put up an LFM and find a rogue or an artificer. Or somebody with those levels. Yes, you can. That rogue friend build is completely free to play, or can be done completely free to play. Fourteen more. And I am going to run the stream over a little bit. Rogue hirelings even exist. Absolutely. Not only in the store. Hi, Zarag. Add you to the list here. You can actually get them in-game at the hireling vendor. So we have rogue hirelings from level 1 all the way up to level 24. And they can be purchased in-game for between 1 and 6 astral shards. You can purchase them for astral shards. So you can get less in here. For astral shards. I don't know why it has a PP cost there. I don't believe you can buy them for platinum. TP needs to be updated. But to DP. But yeah, either 6 astral shards or 40 points. Our hireling section on the wiki is something that's in need of improvement. I was going through making a set of templates and DPL and everything for them. I just haven't completed that project yet. Silver Flame potions are quite popular once you earn Silver Flame favor, reputation. Alright, let me go back to finishing this up real quick. Excuse me. There. Oop. Missed a little bit there, missed an H. I gotta clean up. CE for copy edit. All right, let me go over a little bit further here. Update 18. 19, 18, 17, 16. Updates in there. 13. That will be all of it for that. We've got March 5th, 5 through 18. Events. October 30th to November 6th, November 12th, 21 through the 27th, Is there a page on character transfers? It's a good question. Doesn't look like it. Let's take a look here. Looks like it might be a server page. Character transfer. So there's a section on the server page about character transfers. I don't think I have silent in here yet. Twelve more people. Go away! Quit nagging at me! Alrighty, let's take a look here. Volume 7 added with patch 2. People are going to be like, what's P2? I should link that to patch 2 or make it something that they could mouse over. Ooh, that's horrible. Let's read that instead. Actually, it's commented out. It doesn't even need to be there anymore. Gone. ABBR 2 patch 2 backwards. I can just swap those. See a lot of chatter going on. That's good. I like lots of chatter. That's the whole idea of offering prizes for chat. That one I can fix. 10th anniversary event until April 17th. Hey, Dreads. So I get about 10 minutes left before I do the drawing. We need get your name in now. If you need to, pop into voice chat and let me know. Say, hey, Shoe, add me. You need to be a premium account to win? No, not at all. Well, Barbarian is intended to be a Druid Barbarian combo in a future life. So that's where that came from. Hey, Clyde. There we go. CLYDE frog 0422 added. If I miss your name, send me a whisper. It will pop up and notify me directly right in the corner of my screen over here. So if I've missed your name in the drawing, let me know. Be loud. Be proud. Win a prize. Yay! Say hi in Discord if you need to. Is Double Shot a skill I can use as a first-time character? Absolutely, if you're using something that shoots. Crossbow or regular bow. What program is that for the drawing? That is the DDO code giveaway program. It is something that I wrote myself in Visual Basic. It was originally called Turbine Code Giveaway, but it's not that anymore. I'm probably going to rename it to SSG Code Giveaway or something. You can find it on items. Yep. Then that will add to your double shot. So in order to see what your double shot is, if you go to in-game, right? You bring up your character sheet, and you see this little icon right here? Attack bonuses, double strike, double shot. I have 0% double strike, 2% double shot. It also tells you what your melee and ranged attack speed bonuses are. My ranged attack speed bonus is 10%, which doesn't do me a lot of good as a barbarian. And then this little blue one over here, you can mouse over and tells you your weapon power, melee and ranged weapon power. Melee weapon power is 54, range is 17. Your spell powers are all this purple one up here. It looks like a force missile. Tells you your spell powers, your spell critical chance, and your spell critical multipliers. You can also mouse over your base attack bonus for a description. Any of your stats tell you where it comes from. Base, tome, feats, items. Damage reduction tells you what it is. Resistances. Physical resistance rating, magical resistance rating, spell resistance, armor class will give you a breakdown of your armor class from where everything comes from, tells you your dodge chance as well. And you'll note that I am a female dwarven barbarian. One of the big beefs that I have with LOTRO at the moment is the fact that you can't play a female dwarf. So, if you have any interest in Lord of the Rings Online, and you would like to see dwarven females in Lord of the Rings Online be a playable character, then I encourage you to go on their forums. Zerag's laughing at me. And tell SSG that LOTRO should have female dwarves as well. Apparently they found me hiding in my corner. Exactly. Female dwarves. Mine happens to be wearing, you know, a robe of winter and a pumpkin head, but... yeah, we can make those go away. There. My female dwarf. We need female dwarven beards in DDO. So maybe I'll start a new forum thread for DDO. Say, give us our beards. I'll pop out there. All right, so. All negative numbers means they were all condensed, which is good. Trimmed off some characters. Alrighty. Shrink this for a minute. Pull something else up in the background. Absolutely. So, last Sunday was my birthday. It was my birthday. Happy birthday. And for breakfast, I figured that, you know, there's no better breakfast than a cup of coffee and a nice big old piece of birthday cake. Birthday breakfast. Who wants to have a birthday breakfast with me? All right, so it's 10:24. Time to do the drawing. Alrighty. Birthday breakfast of champions. No, it's a piece of Black Forest cake. So we only got 40 today. We didn't quite have enough. We didn't hit our 50 threshold in order to do the starter pack. So let's save that with our 40 users. Apparently Lotro wants to be loud. Okay. Let's reset. Let's load episode 52. Open. File loaded successfully. Today's prize will be a starter pack. Nope. It's going to be 500 DDO points. That's going to be today's prize. We're only going to need 30 viewers. So we've got our 500 DDO points, 30 viewers needed. We have 40 out of 30. And our winner is going to be Nervgen. We do have 40 viewers, 40 out of 30. We're going to make him because he's a moderator. We'll give him a few minutes to do that. Hey, Nerve, you still there? There he is. I was just about to ping him on Slack. See if he was still there. Oh, turbine's gone, floating screen. Woohoo! Hey, Windows Update, you just missed the drawing. The drawing. Can quit out of that. Move that. I think I'm gonna work on that a little bit today. I'm going to leave that open. Lotro for ya. Turn around. One of the reasons I like Lotro. Oh, blasphemy! It's Lord of the Rings on DDO stream. Is that, I can just stand here AFA. And my bear will take care of everything for me. Go away, kitty. Anyway, everybody have a great week. I don't know if I will be around. Let me bring the other thing up. Oh, I did say I was going to do that. Okay, so here we go. Here is our schedule. This is the most recent schedule that I have. DDO stream.png, is that? I believe that's the most recent. Anyway. So, everybody have a great week. I probably will not be, actually, I will not be on next week. Notified when this channel goes live and follow the Twitter for Dungeons and Dragons Online. Let me find the Twitter page. Come on, where is it? DDO Unlimited, that's what it is. new mic next time. I hope I will have the other mic back by then. It's plugged in charging right now. It's probably fine, but in order for me to swap it over, I would have had to completely restart my system in order for it to recognize the USB microphone. So have a great week. Stay tuned at 1 o'clock for 3 o'clock DDOPL, and then tomorrow there's 4 streams going. Early Morning Rage, which is hosting Sammy Escarobo. The Noontime Weekly Wednesday Lunchtime live stream with Cordovan. DDO as she has played with Gemini at 4 p.m. and Power of a Titan at 8 p.m. On Thursday, we have Dina Dawn with Brighter Days Ahead Tonight. On Friday at noon, we have Friday's Afternoon with Cordovan. At 10 p.m., we have Fridays on Ice with... I forget who that's with. On Saturday, I do not believe we have Damsels this week. I believe that was last week, so it'll be next. It might be this week, though. We have Papa Gallo de TR, which is Nervision's stream, if I remember correctly. Then we have Shikao Zhao Explores DDO on Saturday, and then we run around to Sunday with Cleavebeard, even Minion Monday with the Blue Queen, and then the stream. There was no stream this week as he was having technical difficulties, I believe he said, or maybe he was really sick, I don't remember. And then we're back here next on Tuesday, so no stream next week. Week after that, unsure. But certainly back after that. So, catch everybody later.